mean by biological method? Is it audible?
Sir, biological method means using natural enemies.
Okay, using natural enemies, what will do?
Kill the pest.
What are the natural enemies?
Predator, parasitoid.
Predator, parasitoid, parasites, yes or no? Some other pest also, that means some other, what? Other animals also we can take for management of this, what? Your insect. Yes or no? So anyway, that is your biological form. That means any living organism, okay? Any living organism other than man himself. Yes or no? Utilizing any other living organism except human being itself, we have to manage the pest. We have to manage, not control. Manage the pest. That means you have to reduce the pest population. That is known as what your biological method of pest management. Yes or no? So you see, some historical points are there like this. You just have to remember, suppose this red ant, okay, Orthophylla smaragdina, that is used against which pest? Okay, for citrus, different leaf chewing insect will be there. For them, these ants were used. That means this was the first use of insect predator against pest. This is the case study where first time some insect predator, any other, not any other predator, insect predator was used against another insect. That is first time used in this, what? Orthophylla smaragdina against leaf chewing insect. Then this use of non-insect pest, that is mynah bug, okay? Imported from India to Mauritius. That means it was sent from India to Mauritius to control which insect? Red locust, that is Nomadacris septem fasciata. So what is the example here? Non-insect, that means the birds were used against the insect pest. This was the case study, mynah bug. That's why it is important to remember. This third point is not important. This one is important. Along with the year 1888, you have to remember. What happened here? Can anyone tell? This cottony cushion scale and Badalia beetle, what was the story? What was the story? You see, A2 students and E section, only 28 members are there. What is this? Anyway, what was the story here? Which one is the pest?
Cottony cushion.
Cottony cushion scale is the pest. Okay. What is the scientific name? Isidia purchasi. Yes or no? This cottony cushion scale attacks which plant? Cottony cushion scale is a pest of which plant? It is question from IPM, IPDM, again pest of horticultural crops. Tell.
Citrus,
right. Okay, so this Isidia purchasi was affecting citrus in which country? In, suppose USA, okay? In USA, this cottony cushion scale was attacking citrus. Now, what is the story? What happened? This Sivirile, what he told? That if this cottony cushion scale is a native of Australia, then there must be the associated predator will be there in the Australia only. Okay, that's why what he did? This Albert Coyville, okay? He was sent to Australia to bring that particular predator. Which one is the predator?
Badalia beetle, sir.
Badalia beetle. Okay, what is the scientific name? Rhodolia cardinalis. Understood the story or any doubt is there?
Yes, sir.
Pest is cottony cushion scale of which crop? Citrus. Causing damage in USA. Sivirile was the scientist. What he did? He thought that pest is from Australia means definitely natural enemies will be also from Australia. Who was sent? Albert Coyville. What he brought? Badalia beetle. What is the scientific name? Rhodolia cardinalis. This this much of things you have to know. Case study of 1888. Anything may come in the exam out of this. Understood? What to remember?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
This may come from anything of that. Okay. Similarly, some other example are there. Here, this word. Here, names are not important. Only what is the natural enemy? Cryptolemus montrosari. Okay. What is the pest? Coffee green scale. Coccus viridis. Okay. From which country it was imported? Australia. Into which country? India. Understood? Cryptolemus montrosari was imported from Australia to India to control Coccus viridis. Like this, you have to remember. Similarly, you see here. Aphelinus mali, introduced from England into where? India, to control which pest? Uli apple aphid. Apple uli aphid, that is what? Eriozoma lanigerum. Such kind of questions may come. From which country it came, to which country it came, which parasitoid was introduced, against which pest. Any kind of things may come in the exam. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Similarly, this tachinid fly, you see, Phocosia baziana, it was also imported from Sri Lanka into India for controlling which pest? Coconut black-headed caterpillar. Okay, what is the scientific name? Opicina arenosella. Entomologist, you should remember, huh? Anyway, so now coming to important long question. This one is an important long question, okay? What is that? Techniques of biological control. What are the techniques? Tell.
Introduction, augmentation, and conservation, sir.
Okay, right. Introduction, augmentation, and conservation. Okay. So now coming to what do you mean by introduction?
Oh, Brahma.
Okay, that means you see in centurion what? Corona was not there, but when corona came, we have to import the vaccine. Yes or no? Similar kind of things. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That means,
yes, sir.
What should be the steps? What should be the steps for getting these things?
Introduction first.
What? What are the steps for introduction? First, what you need to identify? The pest, yes or no? How this case is going, drawing on here? I don't know. Some sketches are coming in the screen. Anyway, so first what you need to identify, the pest you have to identify, yes or no? After identifying the pest, what you have to identify in this introduction? From which country the pest came? Suppose you have identified a exotic pest means, then what you have to do? From which country the pest came, you have to identify, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Then you have to go there. Then what you have to find out? The natural enemies associated, yes or no? Suppose from Australia that pest came, that means you have to go to Australia to identify which natural enemies are killing on those pests, yes or no? Then it will become identification of the natural enemies. Then what need to be done? This particular introduction need to be done. That means that particular natural enemies must import into the newly restricted area where the pest has already gained entry. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
This one is what your introduction. Example is this. Bradelia beetle against Cotonicusan scale. Okay. Now coming to augmentation. Here what will happen? Well, what is augmentation?
Here, what's the introduced pest? Sir, that process. will be releasing from natural animals, sir. It will be rearing and releasing from natural animals.
Okay, right. That means what we need to do here, you see, suppose you have some amount of natural enemies with you, but that is not sufficient for releasing them in the field because very few species you have. And if you release them directly in the field, then what will happen? They may die. Either may be due to biotic stress or abiotic stress. The particular environment where they will be introduced, that may not be suitable for them. Yes or no? For that, what you need to do? You have to rear them or multiply them in the lab with some controlled environment which is suitable for them. Now suppose they are mass multiplied. Now this augmentation will be divided into two types. What are those? Inoculative release and inundative release. Yes or no? Inoculative and inundative. Okay. So in inoculative, what will happen?
Sir, means it controlled by the progenies.
Okay, that means how they will control by progeny? That means only once you are releasing. Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Once you are releasing and collecting them.
Okay, right. That is right. Yes, that means as you are releasing them only once, irrespective of the things. That means suppose you have planted the crop after some time. Without thinking anything, we are releasing a large number of individuals in the plot. So here what will happen? No other things you are doing. Simply you have released. Then what will happen? They have to multiply, reproduce on their own so that they can manage the pest. Yes or no? That means here the control, the effectiveness of the control is expected from the progeny. That means from subsequent generations, they will go on multiplying and they will go on suppressing the pest. That one is what? Inoculative release. What is inundative?
Mass release, sir.
Mass release.
It is control from the released individuals. Multiplication of
them. You see, release will be there everywhere, mass only. Not like single individual release. Some more number of release will be there. But in mass multiplication, what will happen? In inundative, what will happen?
Sir, every year we need to release.
Under need, we have to release. Yes or no? That means whenever the pest population will increase, at that time, this mass multiplied population will be released in the field. If required means, that means what? They will be released periodically. Whenever required, they will be released. Whenever not required, they won't be released. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, in inundative, understood or not? That means whenever required, they will be released. Okay. So here the efficiency is dependent on which one? Efficiency is dependent on?
Sir, inoculative.
No. Inoculative efficiency depends on progeny. In case of inundative, that is that will be depending on which one? How many times you are releasing?
Individually.
That means the success will depend on how many times we are releasing the natural enemies. Yes or no? Getting my point or not? In inoculative, it depends on the reproductive rate of the insect, of the natural enemies. But in case of inundative, that will be how many times we are releasing them in the field. Yes or no? On that basis, the success rate will increase. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, so this one is what? All about introduction and augmentation. Now coming to conservation. What is that? Conservation means?
To protect our...
Okay, that means we have to conserve the natural enemies. That means what we need to do? That means whatever the natural enemies are there in the field, now we have to conserve them. That means now we have to protect them. How? We won't do those things. We won't do those things which are unfavorable for them, harmful for them. We will do those things which will be favorable for them. Yes or no? That means we won't apply those broad spectrum insecticides which can kill them. Yes or no? We will apply some narrow spectrum insecticides which will kill the insect but not the natural enemies. Yes or no? We won't do such kind of cultural practices which are harmful for the natural enemies. Yes or no? That means we will plant some those crops which have more pollen source, more nectar source. Because in case of natural enemies, what will happen? In the larva stage, they will attack the insect. But in their adult stage, what will happen? In case of these parasitoids, they will be free living. They need pollen, nectar at that time. Yes or no? This one is what? Conservation. Do those things which are beneficial. Don't do those things which are unfavorable. Okay? That one is what? Known as your conservation. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is what? Conservation. Huh? Just a minute. Okay. Then coming to what is a parasite? What is a parasite? Huh? You see the definition?
Completely depend upon the host. It's internally and externally feed upon the host.
Okay, anything else? You see, again, parasites are divided. Yes or no? Like facultative parasite, obligate parasite. And you are telling they are completely depending upon the other organism. Is it right? No, then why obligate and facultative?
They complete all of their life cycle in their host.
You see, again, same thing you are telling, Sudipta. Yes or no? She is telling completely the dependent. You are telling all stages will be completed within the host. Is it right? Then what is the term of facultative and obligate? Why they are there in classification? That means both the cases will be there. They may be completing their life cycle throughout their life cycle. That means throughout the life cycle in a host, or sometimes they may involve several different hosts. Sometimes for some period of time they will be parasitic. For some period of time they will be what? Free living. They do not depend on any other host. Yes or no? Three categories are there. Either fully or in different host, or for some time in a host, rest of the life cycle in the they are free living. They will feed on the nectar, pollen. Okay, those things will come. Getting my point or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That means you see there is a difference between parasite and predator. What is that? In parasite, the food is known as the food source is known as host. Yes or no?
Host.
Parasite will feed on the host, but in case of predator, food organism is known as, in case of predator, prey. P-R-E-Y. Yes or no? Hello?
Yes.
Prey. Yes or no? In case of predator, what will happen? Whenever, suppose praying mantid or this cryptolemus, ladybird beetle, what they will do? Whenever they will see some aphids or any other small organisms, smaller than themselves, what they will do? Simply they will catch them, they will feed them. That means no previous planning is there. No specific contact or attachment is there. Immediately they will kiss and they will feed. But in case of parasite, what will happen? There will be a proper planning. They need to attach themselves to the host. Yes or no? Without attaching, neither they can get the food nor they can enter into the host. That means there must be an association. There must be a contact in between the parasite and the host. Then either they will lay the eggs over the surface, or they will lay the eggs inside the host, then from the eggs, the larva will come and the larva will go on feeding. This one is what? Your parasite. If laying outside, ectoparasite. If laying inside, endoparasite. If feeding outside, ectoparasite. If feeding inside, endoparasite. Like that, they can be divided. Understood or not? Yes or no? Okay. So why they are attaching means for nourishment and shelter. It may be for food or it may be for their shelter, for living purpose. Okay. That is known as what your parasite. So many other things are there. Yes or no? Like forage is there. Some other components are there. Those are not important here. Anyway, what is parasitism?
the process of where the host will be affected by the insect parasite. This is called the parasitism.
What did you tell? What you told?
So they will take nourishment from the host. Parasite will take nourishment from the host. The process is called parasitism.
All right. That means this is the process where they will get the food from the host. Yes or no? The phenomenon where obtaining the nourishment from the host. Yes or no? By using the host, they are getting the nourishment or food that is known as what your parasitism. Okay. Okay. Then what is parasitoid? What is parasitoid?
In the initial stages, it acts like as a parasite cell. After becoming adult, it will be real free living.
Okay, right, good. That means early stages means which stage?
Larva.
Larva.
Larva. Yes or no? That means
larva stage. Yes.
Yes. That means these are the organisms. Okay, which are parasitic in nature. That means they depend on any other host in their larval stage.
Okay.
But when they will be adult, they will be free living. Yes or no? That is known as what your parasitoid. Yes or no? Yes or no?
He would get to his.
Yes, sir.
You say I'm underlying. You see, from home some noise is coming. You kindly mute yourself. Okay. You see, I have underlined one sentence. What do you mean by that? Insect parasite of an arthropod. What is the meaning of that?
What is the thing?
Okay. So what is the meaning? Insect parasite of an arthropod. What is the meaning? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So tell, what is the meaning? Parasitoid means insect parasite of an arthropod. What is the meaning of that? Insect parasite. Tell.
Sir, insect belong to arthropoda
that means you see, parasitoid means host. okay that means you see parasite, that means parasitoid means they must be an insect first. Yes or no? These are the insect only. Yes, which are parasitic or of or on different arthropods. It may be anything, but the parasite must be insect, then only it will be called as what? Parasitoid. Then in their larval stage they will be parasitic, in their adult stage they will be free living. Understood or not? That is your word, parasitoid. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that one is the parasitoid. Then you see some qualities are there, you read on your own. If any doubt is there, you can ask in the next class. Nothing is there. Okay, they should have high sex ratio, they should have what? They should be able to survive in different wide range of what habitat. They should have more fecundity. Fecundity means egg-laying capacity, shorter life cycle. So many things are there. If any doubt is there, you can ask. Okay, these things are not important. You can read on your own and you can understand. Anyway, then some classifications are there. Okay, like depending upon the nature of host, a parasite will attack the cattle. That means veterinary animals. Then that will be known as cattle pest or zoophagus. Then if they will attack the plants, then phytophagus. If they will attack the insect, then entomophagus parasite. Yes or no? Then you see entomophagus insect. You see two terms are there. One is entomophagus, another one is entomophagus insect. What is the difference? You see, in entomophagus it has been written parasite. In
entomophagus,
but in entomophagus insect that is written as parasitoid. You understood this one? This point you understood now? If anything will be there, that will be parasite. If this parasite will be insect, which is parasitic in larval stages, then that will be known as what, your parasitoid. Understood? Clear? Yes or no? Okay. Now coming to ecto and endoparasite. Okay. What is the meaning of ectoparasite?
Which attack it goes from the outside
and
the
parasite
which is
okay.
From the inside.
Okay.
Outside the body of the host.
That means everything will be done outside. They will attack from outside. They will feed from outside. They will lay their eggs from outside. Everything will be outside. Okay. That is known as what? Your ectoparasite. Understood?
Yes,
understood?
Sir.
Ectoparasite.
Yes,
what is endoparasite? Everything will be inside. Yes or no? That means they will attack by entering inside. They will feed by entering inside. The mother will lay the eggs again inside by puncturing through their ovipositor. They will lay their eggs inside the host tissue. That is known as what? Your endoparasite. Suppose one more case may be there. Suppose what is happening? The parasite has laid its eggs on the food surface. The insect is coming and feeding on that food surface. At that time, what will happen? The eggs will enter inside the meerkat. Yes or no? At that time also, they are known as endoparasite because the eggs entered inside, from which the larva will come and the larva will go on feeding. This is known as what? Endoparasite. Try to remember the example. Nothing is there to tell. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then specialization based on the stage of the host. That means on which stage the parasite or parasitoid is attacking. On that also again they are divided. Suppose the question is, what is egg parasitoid? Or egg parasite, not egg parasite, egg parasitoid. How to define? What is egg parasitoid? What do you mean by that?
They are the insect.
Insect parasite.
Parasite.
The insect parasite will be there. Huh? What will happen? Which stage will attack?
They feed the insect. They are the larva. Immature stage.
Immature. Yes or no? That means larval stage of the insect parasite will attack which stage of the host?
Egg stage.
Egg. Yes or no? That one is what? Egg parasitoid. Example is Trichogramma australicum, Trichogramma, so many species are there. Similarly, suppose larval parasitoid. What will be the definition? Suppose larval parasitoid, what will be the definition?
Immature state of
larva.
Yes, yes or no? That means larval stage of the parasitoid will attack the larval stage of the host. Yes or no? Like that you can define. Okay. So here some examples are there. Try to remember, it may come in the exam. Egg is Trichogramma. Early larval is Appendales. Mid larval is Bracon. Okay. Pupal is Goniogeus nephantidis. Another one is Elasmus nephantidis. Okay. Pupal is Stomatocerus. Okay. Then Trichospilus, Tetrasticus. These are the example of pupal parasitoid. Understood? Try to understand the things, the concept, then you have to just memorize the example. There is no other method. Okay, because scientific names with example you have to remember. Understood? Okay. Okay. So you see, these all parasitoids are there which attacks which pest, that will be your Opicina arenosella. Okay. Coconut black headed caterpillar. You may have studied this one in the pest of horticultural crops. That means in case of management of this coconut black headed caterpillar, these all of the things you have to write down. Okay. This is their effective biological control method for this particular pest, coconut black headed caterpillar. The scientific name is Opicina arenosella. So it may come in the exam. Understood? Both in PHC, yes, and both also in IPT.
Yes,
okay. Now, depending upon the duration of attack, one is transitory, another one is permanent. What do you mean by that?
Jokes aside, pehle batao ye kisne phenka?
Kisne phenka?
लाइफ है, ब्रेक बनता है.
Nestle, good food, good life.
Sir, transitory means few stages of his life on host, a permanent means all the things.
Okay, that means first you take on. Okay, it will be easy if you first define permanent. Permanent means what? Same host.
Which will spends all the stages of his life the same host.
In a specific host, they will complete their whole life cycle. All stages of the life cycle. That is what? Permanent. Now coming to transitory, that means what they will do? Either they will complete all of the stages in different host, or what they will do? They will live as free living for a shorter period of time. They will be parasitic, then they will be free living. Understood or not? Permanent means the same species of host, they will complete all the life cycle. Transitory means they may change the species, or in a stage they will be parasitic, in other stages they may be free living. That is known as what? Transitory parasite. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Transitory, two conditions are there. Okay, one is on different species, another one is or else living as free living. Understood or any doubt is there? Okay. Now coming to your depending on degree of parasitization, that means obligatory and facultative. What is facultative? Okay, first tell what is obligate. Obligate means they cannot live without
the host. Cannot live away from the host.
Yes, that means for a certain period of time also they cannot live without the host. Yes or no? What is facultative? For some time period,
they can live away from it.
They can live without the host. Okay, so that one is what? Facultative. That means what will happen here? You see, this is based on different things. Otherwise, this facultative will be somewhat transitory. Yes or no? This facultative will be somewhat transitory, but this is based on different things. Understood or not? Don't mix up these things. Okay, and don't get confused. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now coming to, you see, depending upon the food habits, polyphagous, oligophagous, and monophagous. Okay. So that means what? Suppose monophagous is there. What is the meaning of that?
Single host.
One host.
Only single species. That means this gonadus will attack only opisthenarvocella. No other species. Okay. Now coming to oligo. What is oligo? Few. Yes or no? Few different host. What is the meaning of that? Isotema javensis will attack only stem borer. That means they won't attack the hairy caterpillar. Hairy caterpillar may be Lepidopteran, but only they will attack the which one? Borer. That means particularly to the Pyralidae family. Understood or not? Monophagous means single species. Oligophagous means family Pyralidae. Polyphagous means whole Lepidopteran order. Understood? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Mono means single species. Oligo means but within the family. Yes or no? With different species. In Pyralidae, sugarcane borer will be there, sorghum borer will be there, then rice stem borer will be there. So many stem borers will come. Yes or no? Pyralidae. But polyphagous means they will attack different species, different families of pests belonging to Lepidopteran order. That is known as what? Polyphagous. Even sometimes if you consider, then that will be whole different insect. Yes or no? That one is what? Polyphagous. Because poly has no limit. Understood? Yes or no?
Then oligophagous means few hosts, but related to the within that family, say.
Yes, that means you see sugarcane and sorghum borer. That means both are belonging to Pyralidae family. Getting the
point?
Yes or no?
Yes.
Species, then family, then order. Understood? Yes or no? Hello.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Am I audible? You see, it is showing your internet connection is unstable. Is it audible and visible?
Yes, sir. Audible, sir. Audible, visible, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. You see, kinds of parasitism. Three are there. This is important. Simple parasitism, super parasitism, and multiple parasitism. Okay. It was there in the question also. You might, I don't know whether you have checked or not. Today only I think I have sent you the Excel sheet. You check once. Okay. What is the mistake you have done? And if correct, that is okay. So now you see what is the difference. In simple, what will happen? In super, what will happen? In multiple, what will happen? Let's go to the whiteboard. Okay. Where is whiteboard? Whiteboard. Do you know where the whiteboard option is there? Yes. What are they? Simple. Okay. Then super. Then multiple. Three things are there. Okay. While understanding these things, you should always keep it in your mind everywhere. One single host will be there everywhere. One single host will be there. Okay. In everywhere, one single individual host will be there. Both in simple, super, and multiple. Now coming to the what is the difference in case of parasite. In case of simple, what will happen? From a single species of parasite, only one individual will attack. Getting my point? A individual parasite is attacking a individual host of same species. Is known as what? Pure simple parasitism. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Understood this one clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now coming to, in case of super, what will happen? Here also, single species of parasite will be there, but here the number of parasites will be more. That means, on a single individual host. Here, host is always individual. One, one, one. Single species, single individual. That is your host. But in simple, what is happening? Single parasite is attacking. But in super, what is happening? So many number of parasites are attacking belonging to the same family or same species. Understood? Not family, species. Understood?
Sir, again, sir.
What?
Again, that super parasite.
Again, okay. So, okay, here you see, in simple, what is happening? Suppose Trichogramma is the parasite. Okay, Trichogramma is the parasite. From this Trichogramma, only one Trichogramma is attacking the one individual host. That is known as what? Simple. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Only one Trichogramma larva is attacking or feeding on the one egg of the host. That is known as what? Simple. What is super? Generally, this won't happen, but still, for example, you see, suppose Trichogramma is there. From Trichogramma, so many Trichogramma are attacking a one individual host. That is known as what? Super. Understood? Only Trichogramma is there, but so many Trichogramma are attacking the individual host. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now coming to another one, multiple parasitism. Here what will happen? Trichogramma will be there and Telenomus is there. Okay. In Trichogramma, so many Trichogramma. In Telenomus, so many Telenomus are attacking a single individual host. This is known as what? Multiple parasitism. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Understood? You see, here two species of parasites are there. So many individuals are there attacking a single individual host. This is known as what? Your multiple parasitism. Understood or any doubt is there? Understood clearly?
Yes, sir.
Sir, once more, multiple parasites.
Multiple. You see, up to super, what happened? In simple, only one trichogramma was attacking. In super, so many trichogramma were attacking. In multiple, what will happen? So many trichogramma, so many another species, telonomous, will attack a single host. That is known as what? Multiple. Understood now?
Okay.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, clear. Okay, so now. Okay, is it visible, this slide? Now visible PDF?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So now you see hyperparasitism. What is that hyperparasitism?
Parasite is attacked another parasite.
Yes, right. Yes or no? That one is what? Hyperparasitism. Okay. So you see, suppose primary parasite. Okay. Primary parasite. What is that meaning? That means some insect are there which is attacking the plant. On these insects, they will parasitize. That is known as what? Parasite. Primary parasite. So definitely they will be beneficial to man. Yes or no? Then coming to secondary parasite. What is secondary parasite? These hyperparasite which will attack the primary parasite.
Secondary parasite.
Yes or no? That means they will feed on the natural enemies. Yes or no? Those will be what you are harmful to men. Understanding or not? Similarly, it will go on increasing. Tertiary, quaternary, like that, it will increase. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Suppose instead of the insect paste, suppose honeybees will be there here. Here, what will happen? The situation, it will be reversed. Yes or no? That means primary parasite will be harmful, secondary will be beneficial, tertiary will be harmful, quaternary will be again beneficial. It will change. The status will change. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Understood? Okay, so these are the things. Okay. This is all about hyperparasitism. Okay. Then somewhat I have told you regarding predator. Okay, that means here what will happen? These are the tell, what is predator? What is a predator?
Predators are the organs which attack the small helpless organs.
The predator are larger than the prey which attacks the prey in single meal, sir.
Okay, right. Yes. Okay, some of the points are here. Yes, right. That means predator will attack on the prey. Prey will be smaller than the predator. These are the generalized predators. That means what generalized means? In case of parasite, what will happen? Somewhat they will be host specific. But in case of predator, what will happen? They are generalized predator. That means whatever they will get smaller than them, they will try to kill them. If they are not producing any kind of what? Scary behavior or any toxins, otherwise they will feed on them. Okay, some other characteristics are there, not required. Okay, then the classifications are there. Okay, based on degree of usefulness. That means you see, shall I tell you these things? You can read, I think. Qualities. Okay, yes, if any doubt is there, you can ask in the next class. Yes or no? Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
These are story, you can read and you can understand.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, based on usefulness to human being, predators can be classified. How? You see, one is entirely predatory. That means they are entirely beneficial to human being. Yes or no? Like green lacewing, tiger beetle, ladybird beetles. Okay. These are what? Entirely predatory. Second, mainly predatory but occasionally harmful. How? These odonata and mantids. Okay? Generally, they are beneficial. They will kill the pest. But sometimes when they will attack the honeybees, at that time, occasionally they may be harmful. That is the meaning of this category. Mainly predatory, but occasionally harmful. Coming to the C. Mainly harmful, but partly predatory. That means occasionally predatory. What is that example? this cockroach and blister beetle, what they will do? Generally, they are harmful. Cockroach is a household pest, and this blister beetle are flower pest. They will feed on the flowers. Generally, they are harmful. But sometimes, what will happen? They will feed on termites. Okay, they will feed on different this blister beetle. They will feed on the eggs of the grasshopper. At that time, they will be occasionally predatory, occasionally beneficial to human being. Understood? Then coming to the D, mainly scavenging but partially predatory. That means example is your earwig. Generally, what they will do? They will feed on the dead and decaying matter. That means they are scavengers. But sometimes they also feed on the maggots. What is maggot?
Immature stage of diptera.
Diptera, good.
Immature stage of diptera.
Diptera, right. Okay, that means generally these earwigs are scavenger, feeding on decaying matter, but sometimes they will feed on maggots. At that time, they will be occasionally predator. That means occasionally they are helpful. Understood? Another one is what? Polyphagus, variable feeding habit, like Tetigonidae. Okay, that means they will are omnivorous, carnivorous, everything. They will feed on eggs, they will feed on plants, they will feed on larva. Okay, whatever they will get, they will feed. Understood? This is what? Variable feeding habit of predators. Okay, and the last one is what? Your stinging predator. This is the exceptional case of predator, which is acquiring the characteristics of parasite. Okay. One more major difference is there in between predator and parasite. What is that? You see, in case of parasite, what will happen? Always they will think of their progeny. That means female parasite will go, attack the host, lay their eggs, they will come out. She will come out. What will feed? The eggs laid on the host, inside or outside, they will hatch into larva and the larva will feed. This is the characteristic symptoms of parasites. Okay, this is the general characteristics of the parasites, always thinking of their progeny. But in predator, what will happen? The predator may be in the grub stage or in the adult stage. Simply they will go on catching the prey and they will feed on them. They won't think about the progeny. Exceptional case is in case of this stinging predator, where what will happen? The mother predator will go. It is in case of spider wasp. Okay, wasp means they can construct the webs, nets. Okay, what they will do? They will construct the net in which prey will be trapped. The prey will be stinged with the mother so that it will be immobile, paralyzed. Then the mother will only lay the eggs and she will go up. Getting my point or not? Prey will come, prey will be trapped, prey will be stinged, prey will be immobile. Now, prey will be laid with eggs by the mother and the mother will go. Then what will happen? From those eggs, grubs will come out and or the larva will come out, in case of wasp, larva, and they will feed on the what? That particular prey. This is the characteristics of stinging predator, spider wasp, which is somewhat showing character of your parasite. Understood? Yes or no? I think the class is more becoming more. Anyway, understood?
Okay.
Or simply telling yes, sir. Anyway, so the differences are there. Most of the things I already have told you. Okay. If anything is there, you can ask. Okay, if any doubt is there, you can ask. It may come in the soft notes or long question. Okay, generally, what are the difference? This is host, that one is prey. These are host specific, that is your generalized predator. Yes or no? Parasites are smaller than the host. Predators are larger than the host. In parasite, ovipositor will be well developed. In predator, their body parts, their wings, their legs will be well developed. Yes or no? Parasites will do with all pre-planning. Predator will simply catch the prey and they will feed on them. So many differences are there. Okay. In case of predator, they have long life cycle. In case of parasite, they have short life cycle. Predator in one day, they can consume 100 number of prey. But in case of parasite, they may consume 1 to 2 or some few host. Not more than that. Okay, so these are the difference of predator and parasite. Or shall I have to tell you each and every point? Tell. Hello.
No, sir.
Do I need to explain each and every point? I think no. Yes or no? You can understand these things. I already have told so most of the things.
No, sir.
Okay. Now coming to biological control of weeds with insect. What do you mean by that? Weeds are pests or not?
Sir, weeds so competition with the plants.
Okay, that means they are the pest. Yes, that means they are the pest. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That means biological control of pest, biological control of insect, weeds. Yes or no? How we can do? Release some insect. Those are pest of weeds. Yes or no? Release those insect which have the weed as the host. Getting my point or not? They will simply go on feeding on the weeds. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But term and condition is that this should not be the pest of another major crop also. Only they should feed on the weeds, but not on the plants. Yes or no? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is what term and condition of biological control agent of weeds. Okay. So now coming to some example, like prickly pear is the weed. Opuntia dillonii is the scientific name. Which biological control can be used? This Dactylopius opuntiae, Dactylopius tomentosus, and Cactoblastis cactarum. Here you see the T should be small letter. Okay, this is wrong. T small letter. Okay. Similarly, Congress grass or carrot weed, Parthenium hystereforus, that can be controlled by this Zygogramma bicolorata. Note it down. Definitely, this question will come in the exam. Zygogramma bicolorata control Parthenium weed. Next is Lantana weed. Scientific name is Lantana camara. And what is the natural enemies by control agent? Ophiomyia lantanae. Another one is Tellionema scrofulosa. Okay. Similarly, some other example are there. This is important. Water hyacinth. Okay. Acornia crassips controlled by Neocetina brucci, Neocetina acornia. Another mite is there. Mite, okay. Orthogalumna terebranthus. It is also a acarina biocontrol agent of weeds. It may come in the exam. Give one example of mite biocontrol agent against weeds. That will be your Orthogalumna terebranthus. All others are your insect. So at least try to remember this first two and the last one. First two and the last one. Okay. Prickly pear. Congress grass, another one is water hyacinth. It may come in the exam. Understood? Rest you may leave. Again, lantana is important anyway. First two and the last one. At least try to remember. Other things you may or may not remember. Understood?
Okay.
First yes, two sir. And the last one. Okay. Understood or not?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Yes, advantages you read, you see story. Okay. Then coming to disadvantage. What is the disadvantage? It is a slow process. Yes or no? That means the pest must what? The natural enemies must be established. They must reproduce. Then slowly, slowly they will go on feeding on the pest. Within that, what may have happened? The pest may have destroyed the crop. Yes or no? This is a major disadvantage. Again, here what will happen? This is somewhat region specific. That means where you have applied, only those areas only they can. But suppress the pest, okay? That cannot be used over a long area. That is also a disadvantage. But if the fecundity is more, the reproduction capacity is more for that particular natural enemies, at that time it is not a disadvantage. Otherwise, it may be a disadvantage. If hyperparasite will be there, suppose you see on a pest, one parasite is there, one natural enemy is there. For that natural enemies, another hyper parasite must not be there. If that will be there at that time, this will be a disadvantage. That means you should not have any hyper parasite. That is also a disadvantage. Last one is story, expensive to develop and to supply biogens. Here you see now what is happening. You can take OET or whatever the government institutions are there. They are having the biological control units. Okay. They are mass multiplying those bicontrol agents like Trichogramma or Brachon habitat. Okay, these people parasitoid testicles. Okay, they are multiplying. But what is the constraint there? No market is there. Farmers are depending more on the chemicals or any other methods as compared to this biological control method. Okay, just like these things. Okay, this is very expensive. Okay, if you give money also, you won't get the market easily. In government institution, what is happening? They are having the collaboration with the but different SOU, different KBK. Thereby, they are selling that one. But in other places, that is not that much effective. Understood? These are the disadvantages. One more is in case of biological control of weeds. That means if they will be the pest of weeds, but they should not affect the plant. If they will affect the plant, then they will be again pest, not the biocontrol agents.